It was right at the beginning of the pandemic, so it took on another light. So many people were wanting to reassure their loved ones in hospitals that, you know, I'm right here, I'm not leaving you. And it was, it just, I guess it resonated with a lot of different types of situations.
Hello, everyone. I'm Brandon Lewis, founder of the Tennessee Conservative, and joining me today is singer, songwriter, and author Kelly Lang. She's here to talk about her new autobiography and music single, I'm Not Going Anywhere, where she shares in word and song her journey of healing as a 17-year breast cancer survivor. She details the ups and the downs of life, which include the unfolding of her love story with country music legend T.G. Shepherd, with the foreword being by friend and fellow breast cancer survivor Dame Olivia Newton-John. The book provides life lessons and showcases Lang's positive attitude during some very trying times. Lang has written music or performed with country music legends such as Lori Morgan, Ricky Skaggs, Lee Greenwood, George Jones, Crystal Gayle, and one of my personal favorites that I interviewed recently, the Oak Ridge Boys, just to name a few. Ms. Lang, welcome to the program.
Thank you, Brandon. Thanks so much for having me today.
Well, I'm excited about it. Tell us a little bit about how you came to be involved in country music and what led you to songwriting and performing in this genre.
Oh my goodness. You know, I just think it was ordained. It was in the stars already, but my dad worked for Conway Twitty as a road manager for 25 years. So I was born into it. I was raised around it. I knew nothing than that. I love to watch Conway on stage, and I thought, man, I got to have some of that. So I wrote my very first song when I was 6 years old, and about 6.5, 7 years old, Conway wanted to move from Oklahoma City to Nashville, which is Hendersonville, which is where I ended up staying, raising my own family. And I'm a huge fan of Oklahoma. I'm grateful to be in the Oklahoma Music Hall of Fame, but Tennessee has really running in my blood now. So I'm really proud to be a Tennessean.
Well, awesome. So if you had to tell one of your favorite music making stories, it could be with your dad, it could be with you, it could be with anything, what would it be?
Oh my goodness. There's too many to list. You know, when you've been around the music industry so long, I thought everybody's family was that. I thought everybody's dad worked for a superstar, and it didn't dawn on me how unique it was. So some of the fun things that I was able to do, I didn't even realize they were that unique or unusual at the time. Just hanging around with some of my favorite artists, you know, I've grown to, it's a really small community. All of them in the music industry, whatever genre it is, have a connection to one another. Like I've met Barry Gibb. I've become friends with him, whom introduced me to Olivia Newton-John, who introduced me to, you know, Marie Osmond. So it's a very small niche that they're family. It's truly a family. And one of my favorite things to do is sit around with them and sing. People think that's crazy. You know, you think you're in the music industry, when would they have time to get together? But the reason they got into the music industry is because they love to sing. And so our organic favorite thing to do is gather around the piano and just sing old songs, old classic country songs. They're our favorites.
Well, I spend my time doing that, even though I have no talent or ability. I've got some friends that play mandolin, banjo, et cetera, and we get together and do the same. And my wife's family comes from a background of that. It's my grandmother, you know, taught me how to do that. And appreciate that on her old AM radio, listening to the Southern gospel greats as she raised me growing up, which leads me to the fact that my grandma had breast cancer. And in the early 1950s, there was really only one form of treatment, and that was, you know, very aggressive mastectomy. Mm-hmm. And she never talked about it. They were of that generation where, you know, even though grandpa was in World War II, he didn't say much, and she didn't say much either. But it takes a lot of courage to face this disease. It takes even more to talk about it publicly. Tell us a little bit about your story and how you've used your musical talents to provide some comfort to those who are fighting the same battle.
Well, Brandon, thank you for saying I'm brave. I don't feel brave in any way. I think you just get handed cards and then you choose to crumble or stand up, you know. And I had two little girls when I was diagnosed at 36 years old. I was a single parent, so I had to do something to keep myself strong looking for them. And I had been in the music industry prior to that era, but I had taken some time away from it to raise my kids. And so when I started dating TG, we started performing together some and started, you know, back into my music career, which, you know, I think music is healing altogether. But the inspiration from other people came a little later. I was too scared to talk about it. I just wanted it in my past. I didn't want anybody to really know anything about me or assume that I was just a breast cancer patient. I had more to say. So I was reluctant to share my story, but I saved all the notes that I had written down from my era that I was being diagnosed. And I found them during the pandemic. And when I was looking through all of these, this original doctor's notes and my feelings about them and all, my friend Kim Fannin said, you should write a book. I think 17 years later, you could be of help to somebody. And, you know, it made such sense to me because I didn't have anybody to really, you know, I didn't have a light at the end of my tunnel as far as somebody closer to my age that it could relate to what I was going through. So all of a sudden I realized I might could help somebody by being a ray of hope somehow with these words. So I really took myself and it was a very raw and intimate way of telling that story. But I felt like it had been in me for so long. And selfishly, I didn't want to go there. But I feel like with all of the letters that I'm receiving now, people telling me that my book is helping them and how encouraged they are. And then now all these years later, becoming friends with Olivia Newton-John, who wrote the foreword for my book, as a matter of fact, she has taught me single-handedly how to be an example for others. She's going through breast cancer herself again, but she's living with it. She's living with a smile on her face, even though. And I believe that some of the things that I've written about in my book teaches us how to go through really rough times and with a smile and with a better attitude than I had before.
Guys, if you appreciate what we do here at the Tennessee Conservative, if you will go to TennesseeConservativeNews.com/support or hit the support button, and when you give, you get two proud Tennessee Conservative bumper stickers. You can use this to patch things around your house. You got a flat tire, you're going down the road, take one of these puppies out, slap it on it, drive on. These things are so adhesive. They really are. I mean, I've seen this thing pull aluminum off of a refrigerator. I mean, they are made of something. Once you put it on there, it will never come off. I'm just letting you know, fair warning. It'll be there for eternity. If you give $50 or more, or if you make a recurring donation, you get this proud Tennessee conservative tumbler. With all the news coming out here lately, I've had to drink a lot of cold beers out of this, and I believe it has revitalized my health and turned back the clock, and perhaps even pauses aging. I'm not quite sure what magical properties are imbued in this, but it can be yours. And we also send you this handy official directory of all your state reps and your state senators, which many of you use profusely during the special session. And that's why many of us got our medical freedoms back. And finally, if you go to letsgobrandonhat.com, you'll get this puppy right here. And everybody wants one of these heading into the holiday season. We've only got a few of these puppies left, so if you want one, get them while they're hot. Well, it is rare that someone can author a book. I mean, that's a big undertaking. A lot of people set out to. They want to. Everybody wants to write a book. Everybody feels like they've got a book in them, but you have to go through the process, which can be difficult. And at the same time, have the ability to do something musically is doubly powerful. Talk about, you know, how you were able to do that with both your book and your single, I'm Not Going Anywhere, and where could people listen to it, read it, get it?
Well, I believe this is all really God's plan, because 17 years ago, I wrote the song, I'm Not Going Anywhere. And then a few months after I wrote it, I needed to hear those same words because I had then been diagnosed. And my husband now, boyfriend at the time, T.G. Shepherd, says, I'm not going anywhere. I'm right here. I got you. And I'm like, I really needed to hear my own words, you know. So he cut it with Crystal Gayle. It was in a Burt Reynolds movie called The Deal. And You know, I just kind of laid there. It really didn't do any more than that. So imagine my surprise, 16 years later, Ascension Hospitals picked it up for their national campaign. And I began, it was right at the beginning of the pandemic. So it took on another light. So many people were wanting to reassure their loved ones in hospitals that, you know, I'm right here, I'm not leaving you. And it was, it just, I guess it resonated with a lot of different types of situations. It was actually likened to You Light Up My Life by Debbie Boone, because it can go in weddings or funerals or, you know, just, it's just an unusual dynamic. So that is where we came up with the title for the book as well, to correlate along with that, because we released it as a single once we realized how many people were being affected by the words and the music from that. And I think it's just a happy accident, as Bob Ross would say.
Well, if somebody wanted to find it, procure it, listen to it. I listened to the single 2 or 3 times. I'm an audiophile. You have a fantastic voice. You have a great delivery. That's not just me kissing your butt. If I can't say anything nice, I just don't say anything. But it is a great delivery. And it's a beautiful song. Where would somebody hear that? And then where would somebody, if they wanted to get a copy of your book, where would they go?
Well, you can always go to kellylang.net. And you can get anything Kelly Lang there. But we're running a kind of a special right now where you can get the audio version. It's a CD EP. It's the piano version, orchestrated version, and how the story behind the song. And that's also being included as a package with the book. So we're doing a bundle pack with that. And it's autographed. So I think it makes a good Christmas gift if somebody's looking for something more personalized, or a gift for someone going through a possible cancer diagnosis as well. The book is not only about cancer. It's about music industry. It's about behind the scenes of artists' lives and working in the industry, and funny things, crazy funny things that I've gotten myself into, people that I've met along the way, and lessons learned. The one thing I love about my book is that we've included QR codes after every chapter. So if the person would like to see a video or a little bit more about the story, or I felt like I didn't get enough words in it so I could share something else, you can use your phone and actually use the camera on your phone to scan the QR code, kind of like we do in restaurants. For instance, I'm talking about my appearance on Star Search. And right after that chapter, you can touch your scan and you can see 18-year-old me on Star Search with Ed McMahon. So every chapter has a different video that correlates with what you've just read. And it's very interactive. I think people are really enjoying that part of it. Also, you can get my music on Amazon, anywhere music is downloaded, but Amazon also offers the hard copy and paperback and ebook, not autographed, of course. But if you're like me, I like old school. I like to hold the book in my hand.
Well, as do I, and I always like to keep things in the library that can be handed down to future generations and have kids and grandkids browse through the books. So you've been very kind with your time, Ms. Lang. I will let you have the last word.
Well, I would like to let everyone know how proud I am to be from Tennessee. I'm born in Oklahoma, live in Tennessee. If you can share my song Under a Tennessee Moon with all of your listeners, I think anybody that loves Tennessee will appreciate the words in that.
Well, we will put that puppy out on both social media, and we will place it in the e-newsletter that will go out with this, both on our website and other places. I love good traditional country music, and I want to help keep it alive. Ms. Lang, you've been very kind. I'm so glad to have you here. I appreciate all of our subscribers to the Tennessee Conservative. And if you've enjoyed this, you can find more at TennesseeConservativeNews.com. Do go check out KellyLang.net to get the book, to listen to the song, and to find out about what Ms. Lang is doing to help people through a difficult time as they struggle with something that many people do. Until next time, I'm Brandon Lewis, the Tennessee Conservative, signing off.
Thanks, Brandon.